Fünftes Match dieser zweiten Session des European Darts Matchplay 2017. Wir kommen zu einem jungen Belgier, der vor allem auf der Development Tour unterwegs ist, dort in diesem Jahr seinen zweiten Sieg eingefahren hat und er deshalb auch noch kein PDC-Ranking hat. Wir sind gespannt auf Kenny Neyens. Kenny Neyens tritt an gegen den BDO-Weltmeister aus dem Jahre 2014. Seit 2015 ist er bei der PDC und er hat sofort einen Riesenstart in die PDC-Zeit gehabt, konnte sich bis zur Premier League spielen und hat zuletzt ein paar Probleme. Ist aus dem Top 20 rausgerutscht, er will dringend wieder zurück in Richtung Top 16, die aktuelle Nummer 21 der Welt. Herzlich willkommen hier in Hamburg, The Bullet, Steven Bunting! Partie ist ein Mann, der heute seinen ersten European Tour Tag bei der PDC hat. You were!
Well, a former champion of the world, Steven Bunting on stage. Not him, that's Hugh What, When, Where. The Bullet, there he is. Steven Bunting, former Lakeside champion, former world master, and a player with a phenomenal youth record when he first started out, but he's taking on the promising young Belgian talent, Kenny Neyens, who beat Ronnie Huybrex, his fellow Belgian, in qualifying before seeing off Vincent van der Meer convincingly to make it through to the Happy Bet European Darts match play. The winner of this one will face the Cobra, Jelle Klaassen. I'm Dan Dawson, Rob Malarkey alongside me for this one.
Yeah, I've got to say, looking forward to seeing Kenny Neyens in action on the Euro stage. He has played on the Euro Tour before. That was in the Dutch Darts Masters 2 years ago, but he was beaten in the first round by Kyle Anderson. Well done if you remember that, by the way. It was a very short-lived affair, but he's back, and he's back a very different player, you have to say, as well, because he's making giant strides.
Steven to throw first. Game on!
Currently fourth in the development tour standings after 12 events so far this year, winning one as well, reaching the final in a couple of others.
97.
And on the evidence of what he's done over the last 12, 18 months, you have to say he's another one to watch. We talked about the emerging Belgian talent earlier on, and he's very much in that bracket.
40.
Yeah, well, an inauspicious start to this one from
Neyens. You have to bigging him up.
Yeah.
But, you know, big occasion.
It is. I'm not sure they've played
100
in front of a crowd this size. The Dutch Darts Masters, I believe, when he featured in that, probably didn't have a capacity
46.
As large as the 1300 crowd we've got in for tonight, who have been
bouncing off the walls this evening. They have been treated to some drama today. Three players who've been beaten today have missed a total of 10 match darts before getting knocked out of the tournament, with Chris Dobie being the latest one, missing four match darts against Peter Jakes. Kenny Neyens is having what is 45. Known professionally as a bit of a mare in this opening leg. 131 points scored after three visits.
Well, the crumb of comfort is that it's on the Bunting throw. Just get this out of your system and move on.
Yeah.
May still
bound
win this
to be
leg.
A bit of nerves.
Absolutely.
Taking on a former world champion.
140.
It's a lot better.
You require 80.
Oh dear, well that's not what he wanted, so we'll look at 25 for tops.
Games
yeah, lovely stuff.
Stephen Bunting,
ropey first dart, but clears it up very nicely for a level 15 darter and a 1-0 lead.
60.
Kenny Neyens, one of the players to have hit a 9 dart leg this year. We've had 19 perfect legs so far this year on the PDC Tour.
Have we had one on the European Tour?
Not yet, no, but I'm just wondering if Kenny Neyens can bring that one he had on the development tour into this.
Well, it would be
on
nice.
On the evidence of what we've seen so far.
140!
He'll be glad for a couple of 180s anywhere along the way.
Well, 140 there, and he's 100 points clear in this leg.
60!
So, chance for Neyens just to work his way into this one. Wiry, whippet-like young
91.
Belgian. Probably two adjectives you wouldn't use to describe Stephen Bunting.
100.
Yeah, it does look like the sort of guy who could be blown over by a gust of wind, Kenny Neyens.
40.
Well, 40 does get him down to a finish.
But Bunting could take control of this leg here.
Oh, he really could.
Couldn't he just?
140. Can you require 170?
Well, it'd settle him down, wouldn't it? Oh, disgusted with himself.
98. Stephen, you require 101.
Now then, for a 2-0 lead. Lovely dart. Double 16.
Games
there it
on
is.
The second leg.
Classy
Stephen
dart.
Bunting.
From Stephen Bunting,
third leg, Stephen
the world
to
champion,
the first
back-to-back 15 darters, a 2-0 lead, and punishing Neyens.
And a brutal illustration, really, of what Neyens is up against here tonight, as
95.
Well as the big stage nerves, the big night nerves, and the big crowd nerves as well. Bunting with a ruthless 101 checkout just to press home his authority. That's more like it.
Well, look, I mean, the standard of darts is not going to... I don't think it'll terrify Neyens, because you see what happens on the
100.
Development tour on a regular basis, and these guys are throwing incredible stuff. You talk to some of the markers on the PDC circuit, and they say the stuff they see on the development tour is often
140.
Better than they see on the challenge tour, and we've seen some of the great stuff we've had on the challenge tour. So, you know, it's the consistency that isn't there for a lot of the young lads. That's what they have to learn to build into their game. So Neyens will be quite happy going toe-to-toe with somebody averaging 100, but can he do it
49.
On this stage, in this atmosphere, with big money up for grabs? I know winning a development tour, you get $2,000. I mean, it's good prize money. But, I mean, it's $1,000 just for being here in the first round. And it goes
50.
Up pretty quickly.
Yeah, there was the increments of £500 last year, but it's now £2,000 for getting to round two, as opposed to £1,500 this time last
50.
Year.
50. Stephen, you require 150.
He's scratching away here is Neyens. And Bunting, 150.
60. Kenny, you require 128.
Maybe just the inkling of an opening here for Neyens. Not anymore, there's not.
And like that, it's gone.
44.
Now, Bunting,
Stephen,
you would think
90.
He looks at the 20s first. Some players will go ball. Some players will go treble 18. But in this situation, well, he has gone ball. Does he go another 25? No, he goes 15 and he misses the big number. And that is criminal. Because it actually looked quite inviting for the bullseye had
back.
He hit the single 15.
Yeah.
66.
Well.
Can you require 84?
That'll do. 14. For ball.
59. Stephen, you require 24.
Well, Bunting may have got away with that missed. Dart at 15. because he's found double 12.
Stephen Bunting.
And Neyens looks to the heavens.
And he's, to throw first.
I think, looking to
Game
the sky
on.
For some sort of inspiration, but he won't find any there. All he'll see are the bright lights above the stage, reminding him of exactly where he is.
60.
And in the blink of an eye, Bunting is 3-0 to the good hit. No whitewash today so far.
60.
Couple of 6-1s to start things off at the very start of the day.
Yeah, but most 85. Of the games after that have been very close. Mike Dedecker, Max Hopps 6-2 to Mike Dedecker, and one of the young Belgians is through to the next round, but everything else has been 6-3, 6-4, 6-5.
40.
And Neyens, well, you mentioned that it was a pretty brief appearance at the Dutch Darts Masters in his Euro Tour debut. He is in danger, if something doesn't change here, of having an equally brief stay in Hamburg this weekend. Just taking a moment, and I think that shows...
34.
Took a moment, but he might have been better off just ploughing on there, really.
I don't know, at least he's trying something. He's trying just to ride the nerves or control whatever is going through his
100.
Head or the adrenaline. He's at least trying something. He's not just ploughing on regardless. And look, there we go. This is more like it.
Snarl, though, 85. As he fails to back it up with anything significant.
This is a Belgian trait. He's got a real sort of Kim Heibrichs rodent-like bearing of the teeth up on the stage there.
Gnarling away. 125. An imaginary piece of wood.
Yeah.
Neyens was bageled, whitewashed, call it what you will, in the semi-finals of the World Youth Championship
100.
Last year by Barry
Stephen
Van Peer.
You require 76.
Title won by Corey Cadby.
Tops for 4-0.
Games
and there it
the
is. It's
leg.
Another 15 darter. Stephen Bunting in complete control of this
fifth
one.
Leg, Stephen to throw first.
And apart from
Game
that
on.
Third leg, where Neyens did get an opportunity. You see, Mike Dedecker, his fellow young Belgian there, and I think he was just saying, calm down. And I think probably Kenny may well be quite aware that's what he needs to do, but knowing you've got to do it and being able to do it are two completely separate things, particularly when you're 4-0 down to
60.
You know, a man who, although his fortunes have not been great over the last... I mean, it's October was the last time Stephen Bunting made a quarterfinal. Mm. It's not been great for him this year. He is still Stephen Bunting,
60.
The former champion of the world and world master and former Premier League player, and the man who beat Phil Taylor at the European Championship, and a man who's won two PDC titles. He is still a name.
42.
Yeah, and just to echo that point as well, 12 players' championship events this year he's been involved in. He suffered a first-round defeat in 8 of them. It's been that sort of year for Stephen Bunting.
140.
So
and yet... On the Euro Tour is where he's had his best runs.
Yeah, he's 10th in the European Order of Merit.
Yeah, he keeps making the last 16, does he? He keeps making the final day, winning a couple of games.
99.
But then, or one game, I mean, he was seeded, wasn't he, for a few of them?
That's the thing, yeah.
So he doesn't have to win much to get through to the last 16, but he was doing it.
He had to qualify for single figure.
60.
For the rest, he's been seeded for, yeah.
Qualifying here, beating...
And in fact, in single figure, when he... was seeded, when he was a qualifier, he got drawn with Adrian Lewis as well, so that was the downside of all that.
55.
Yeah, he beat Stephen Burton and Steve Hine in qualifying for this one, Stephen Bunting. But he is making very short work of his Belgian opponent
60.
At the moment, who is really struggling to get to grips with the occasion. You see him shaking his head, and...
He could do with a timeout or something.
Yeah.
Here, couldn't he? I mean, if, I don't know if there's such a... Well, clearly there isn't such an opportunity for him.
Stephen, you require 124.
You just pull, there's a draft and walk off stage and give yourself 15 minutes. It's worked for others.
Feign injury. Buy yourself a bit of time.
56.
But the damage is
done here. Require 150.
I think Mayans just maybe...
Oh.
Well, maybe there's signs of life here.
Oh,
maybe.
My word.
114.
Well.
Stephen, you require 68.
So close to a big finish.
This will really hurt now because having gone so close to a spectacular checkout, Bunting could do some damage here.
Gage on the fifth leg, Stephen Bunting.
Well, that is the second time where Stephen Bunting has come
to
the board looking at a finish in the sort of 60 to 80 range. His first start has been poor, but then his next two have been perfect. And
57.
It has got to be just draining for Neyens to stand there and watch.
Yeah, I mean, for that to come hot on the heels of a missed opportunity, take out 150. 150 checkout there for Neyens would have done him the world of good.
Well, it could have changed the game because, I mean, Bunting's only averaging 88. He's not doing anything spectacular here. However, let's see if we can show you the checkout. Because Bunting, even though he's not scoring brilliantly, I've just said that he's going to whack in a 180.
140.
His finishing has been flawless. And that is quite astonishing.
Can't get more flawless
98.
Than that.
No, you can't. We saw a great display of finishing earlier on from Peter Hudson the first game of the day when he only missed one dart at double. Stephen Bunting might be about to eclipse that.
Ooh. 78.
But a chance. Neyens, he's had a couple of darts at double. Can he give himself more here? Good adjustment. Really good start. Well done, Kenny Neyens.
Better leg this. He had a 140 and then a 125 and he's down to a finish of 81. Can he
100. Can he
get a leg
81?
On the scoreboard here? Let's hope he can.
12. Even double better. 13.
55. Stephen, you require 124.
He's already had 1 ton plus. He took out 101. 124 for Stephen Bunting. Treble 18 for ball. But he sets it up,
Kenny,
and Neyens has to take
26.
This out, or it could be another 6-0 defeat.
Games on the sick leg.
The agony ends
Kenny
there,
Neyens.
And an ironic celebration, I think, more than anything.
Seven
and it gets the nod of approval from Mike Decker. Decker, of course, safely through to round two. But Kenny Neyens, well, who knows?
85.
I think 6-0 would have been cruel for him. It would have been devastating for him, and he has got a leg on the board at last.
100.
But that was promising because, like I say, he had some significant visits there. He seemed to start knitting things together.
Well, the average has moved into the 80s. It's something. And, you know, I mean, he's taken him 12 legs on the European
28.
Tour to win a leg. But he's got one now. And the only way is up.
80.
And you never know, Stephen Bunting, having been sat on 32 for a 6-0 whitewash victory and not getting a chance to have a go at it, maybe...
55.
Maybe he thinks this game is already won. Maybe he takes his foot off the gas. And maybe Neyens can take advantage.
55 is met with...
180!
And all of a sudden, he's moving in the right direction here, and Stephen Bunting might be anxiously looking over his shoulder all of a sudden. Neyens gets a break here, who knows?
58.
And it's another visit without a trouble here for Bunting. Now then.
Oh my word, double 12. 12.
129.
Well, he will be back because Bunting's on 275, but what about this for a break or a potential break? Potential 13 darter here for Neyens.
Well, this is a completely different
59.
Kenny Neyens. And you wonder,
12.
Had he got, say, that third leg on
Ginge
the board,
on the seventh leg.
Maybe
Neyens.
This would have been different. And he storms
leg,
to the
Kenny
board,
to the
yanks his darts out.
He wants to get on with this now.
Is that a little smirk from Decker? Well, he was telling him to calm down earlier. He wants to tell him to get fired up.
125.
Well, if anything, even if he does go on to lose this now, at least he's given himself or he's had the opportunity to show people what he can do. Bunting showing what he can do here as well.
180!
Just a little reminder there for Kenny. Bunting
85.
Just telling everybody that he is still in control of this match at 5-2.
Oh, well, he certainly is now.
Four perfect darts make that five.
140!
The dream dies once again here in Hamburg. Take your time. This is the time to calm down, Kenny.
70.
Yeah, you see. A little of anger and frustration in that last dart. Flying into the five. Bunting looking to leave himself something manageable. And he does exactly that. 88 remain. Two darter for an 11-dart checkout and a 6-2 victory for Stephen Bunting to set up a clash
91.
With the Cobra Yellow Class
Stephen
and another former
88.
Lakeside World Champion. Treble 20 for double 14. Now it's 18 ball. Bullseye.
63.
One match dart miss.
Kenny require 130.
Well, Kenny Neyens has been beating himself up at every opportunity here. 110 away. And he does not get the opportunity.
90.
And once again, there's a bit of venom in that final dart. And he's actually hit the bullseye anyway.
Shaking the head from Kenny Neyens there. It was plumb in the middle of the bullseye, but it might be the last dart he throws in this one. 8 for Bunting.
9.
Well, it's 3 match darts now.
And it's not the last dart that Neyens throws.
Can you require 40?
And who knows, we may be moving into a 9th leg
game
here, and we are. Look at this now. Look at the passion getting the crowd
ninth
involved.
Leg, Stephen 2 throw first.
Well, seen it all now. Bunting just looking a bit hot under the collar here, isn't he? Well, even Paul Nicholson's out of his seat for the
44.
Ninth leg. Joining us in the gantry for this one. Can't take your eyes off it now. It's an absorbing encounter. Look to be
60.
Done and dusted inside 10 minutes, this one, but anything but now.
Well, I remember seeing Daryl Gurney at the World Championship against Mark Webster, and Daryl Gurney essentially managed
97.
To sulk his way to victory after falling out with the crowd. Kenny Neyens may be about to win in a similar way, but rather than the sulking, he's
57.
Basically had a massive tantrum, and it has turned the game in his favour.
It's Mike Dedeko, mind guru.
It's Mike Dedeko is telling him to calm down. He's done
41.
The exact opposite and stormed back into contention in this match.
Yeah, Dedeko's played his part, there's no doubt about it. Ever since the camera first picked him out, and we saw the body language, the exchanges,
45.
The knowing glances. It's completely changed. That said, Neyens isn't there yet. He's still got plenty to do here. You'd rather be in Bunting shoes at this point in time. Still, just about.
Well, we've seen a succession of very odd games today on the opening day of the Happy Bet European Darts Match Play, and this is right up there amongst the oddest. Because Kenny Neyens is wild up there. He is stomping around like a kid who's been grounded and had his pocket money taken off him for the month. And sometimes it's producing very good stuff, sometimes it isn't. But Bunting is going to get more match darts. He missed 3 in the last leg. He's going to get another 3 here minimum for a 6-3 victory.
40.
And to send Kenny Neyens to bed without any dinner. Topsy wants.
Game
and Topsy
and
gets
match.
Kenny Neyens.
Stephen
well, he avoids the 6-0 whitewash that was his Euro Tour debut in the Dutch Darts Masters. He's shown a little bit of what he's about here in Hamburg. But the bullet, Stephen Bunting, makes it through round 1 and will take on Jelle Klaassen in a clash of the former Lakeside World Champions. We've got 3 more spots in the second round up for grabs, but coming up here in Hamburg, it is the game of the day. 2-time world champion Adrian Jackpot Lewis against the former UK Open finalist Vincent van der Voort.
Kenny Neyens, ich glaube ein Name, den wir uns merken sollten, von dem werden wir mit Sicherheit noch in den nächsten Monaten, in den nächsten Jahren viel, viel mehr hören. War ein bisschen spät ins Match hineingekommen, trotzdem noch ein paar Lecks an Land holen können. Am Ende ist es aber Stephen Bunting, der hier in die zweite Runde einzieht und damit morgen auf Jelle Klaassen trifft. Stephen, congratulations. It looked very easy at 5-0, and then it got closer.
Sometimes you relax a bit too much. I took my foot off the gas, and you should never do that, no matter who you're playing. I've known Kenny for a lot of years. We go back all the way to the BDO. I remember when he was a young boy, practicing in the Belgium Open, and he used to play him and Dimmy. So I've got a lot of respect for him, and thankfully today I was 5-0 up, because you can never fall asleep.
We see really more and more young boys playing the PDC circuit. When did actually you start? When did you knew? Okay, I'm going to be a professional player.
From a young age, really playing at home, and I won the Lancashire Open, which is a local tournament for me. When I was 15 years old, beating Darrell Fitton in the final. And from then, I thought I could make this. Put a lot of work in behind the scenes, what people don't see, and. I'm where I am today. I never moved over to the PDC till, 3-4 years ago, so pretty late, but love every minute of it.
Not too late. Tomorrow you play Jelle Klaassen, one of the best European Tour players in the last couple of tournaments.